Hello, everyone, and welcome to Operation Vigilant Guard. I'm Rob Dew.
Jason Douglas.
And we were in Chicago from June 12th to the 17th covering this Operation Vigilant Guard terror exercise.
And military exercise, international policing apparatus.
Yeah, it pretty much went the gamut from, you know, local agencies all the way up to national agencies working together to save us from the terrorists. And so we're going to start off with June 13th. It was a terror drill in Oak Lawn, simulated plane crash. And we're just going to let these guys talk because they pretty much tell the story. And this is about 30 minutes long, so sit back and hope you learn something.
My name is Dr. Sanford Block, and I'm the director of the Cook County Medical Examiner's Disaster Response Team. And we are here to participate in a statewide drill with the National Guard. We are starting off this exercise. The initial event today would be a plane crash. The plane is coming into Midway Airport and explodes over the municipality of Oak Lawn. There are 350 fatalities. We've been requested to come out here and assist them in the recovery and the identification of the victims.
Walking wounded, come this way.
We start off this initial Vigilant Guard event, the National Guard event, and we will demobilize today. There'll be other events occurring during the next 3 days in different areas of Chicago and Cook County. It's approximately 2 to 3 hours it takes us to set up an off-site morgue. It's called the MEDU, the Mobile Emergency Disaster Unit. It's stationed out at O'Hare International Airport. It is available to not only the county, but also coroners in the state, should they need it for a catastrophic event.
Obviously, there'd be some challenges if we were to have an incident, but this exercise will help us work through those challenges, work better as a team.
Okay, perfect, and so far, so good.
So far, so good, yeah.
He has the 56-member disaster response team that also helps to assemble the unit before we go out in the field for recovery.
So there we go, yeah. So, so Jason, what were your thoughts while shooting this footage? What were you thinking?
Well, we weren't really supposed to be there. Most media checked in, and we were kind of just gonzo journalisting. There was lots of military walking around and being official. It was their first day, so I think they were, you know, kind of not knowing what was going on and
Right. Putting
it together. As we saw later on, there was a little bit of disorganization going on.
We finished with that. We went into Chicago, shot some stuff. Jason spotted this great seal in a federal building.
And I almost wrecked the car.
So I jumped out and went and shot it. And I pause it here at the bottom. You can actually see it says Novus Ordo Seclorum.
Mm.
So here comes the next day. We went to Toyota Park, which is a stadium, big soccer stadium, and that's where the National Guard had set up a staging ground. We interviewed a colonel there, and you know, this is what he had to say.
Johnny Miller, I'm a colonel in the Illinois National Guard. Toyota Park is mainly the location where we receive all of our logistics support for this operation. All the National Guardsmen will come here, and so we know all the players we have involved in the operation, and then they'll move out to subsequent locations from here. Having places like this available in any of the areas, any part of the state we're at, is critical for us to be successful. It's a good venue for parking. We have plenty of places to stage logistics, stage personnel, stage equipment. We can bring soldiers here to sleep. They can be fed here, showered, and then move on out to conduct operations. Our partner country with Illinois is Poland, so we'll have Polish military folks here because they're getting ready for the World Cup in 2012 there. And we'll also have people from their agencies that are similar to our civilian agencies where they're learning police activities, for some of the operations we're doing are more law enforcement than military in nature. Okay. And whenever an opportunity comes up like that, we let that be known to the Polish military, and they share it with their other Polish government partners. And we heard, of course, from law enforcement, and like we have Illinois Counterterrorism Task Force, and Poland has a version of that, and so they're interested in these type of exercises to better train their personnel. So we just use it as an opportunity to share the shared experiences and make all of our agencies better. There'll be some in uniform and some will be civilians. You know, okay. We have some that are, for example, I think it's listed in here. For the international agency, we've got folks from the Polish consulate here in Chicago. Land Forces, which is the Polish Army, they'll be here. Polish National Fire Service, they're getting some experience here. Ministry of the Interior Administration, and then the Bureau of Counterterrorism Operations. So they're sort of like the FBI.
Okay.
And then Republic of Latvia is also here. So they have, I think they also have a role in that World Cup that's coming up in Poland. So, and they do a lot of partnership with that as well.
And this seems like the biggest bone of contention for the entire project. You know, is it okay for us to be working with foreign military and foreign powers in order to police our own citizens and territory?
Also foreign police. You know?
Foreign police, foreign military, foreign... you know, secret governments.
Okay, I'm Sergeant First Class Mark Ballard with the Illinois National Guard. I am one of the exercise controllers who is running the simulation cell for this exercise. Here out of the sim cell, we will just be providing guidance, directions, requests for information from the responding forces to keep the information flowing between the response agencies in Bensonville up through the area command and whatnot. This is IEMA's Unified Area Command trailer. It's a new piece of equipment that the state's acquired in the last year, and it's been brought in to just test out, make sure its capabilities are working. It's able to communicate with all the other elements that are out there. The forces from Poland that are joining will be integrating into some of the civil military units that are participating in this exercise. The state of Illinois has an alliance, a state partnership program with the Republic of Poland. And across the last several years, we have been doing integrative training and coordination with them, sharing information and learning from one another as part of the state partnership for peace program. Bringing them over and incorporating them into the civil military domestic response role is just increasing that awareness and visibility of what the role of the National Guard is, and is helping them to understand how their military forces can integrate with their civilian forces in the event of a civil situation that takes place. The Illinois National Guard has a no-fail contract with the state of Illinois to provide services protection to the citizens of the state. And in working with our partner agencies to respond to these types of situations, we have to train and exercise with them as much as possible. Training and exercising is the cornerstone of successful response in an emergency situation.
So increasing the visibility, or making us think that this is what the responsibility of our National Guard is.
National Guard is supposed to work with foreign governments to promote peace throughout the world. I didn't know that was their job. Here's some more fabulous Douglas B-roll right here. The troops getting ready and setting up their decom tents for the various exercises on the 14th. It's the 14th of June. So then we go on to the meth lab takedown.
Day three.
I'm Captain Joe Bright. I'm the program manager for the SURF-P program for the Illinois National Guard. I'm here with Mitch Lejak from the Polish Epidemiological Response Center of the Polish Armed Forces. We're here participating in a Homeland Security exercise. We'll be working on military support to civil authorities as part of a terrorist scenario where they have a biological weapon. Major Lejak and the Polish Armed Forces have a partnership program with the Illinois National Guard. We do cooperative training and exercises, and it's been very beneficial to both of our services in helping us develop our capabilities. The exercise today and what you'd expect to see will be some terrorist scenarios in which there are multiple casualties. We'll have search and extraction team that will be extracting casualties from different facilities. Those personnel that are extracted would be contaminated potentially with a biohazard, so we'll have a mass casualty decontamination team that will decontaminate them, and then we have a medical triage and treatment team that will provide medical care to them before they're moved by ambulance, if necessary, to a hospital or other type of long-term care facility. You'll see National Guard cooperating with civilian authorities. Typically when we respond, we only fall under a civilian incident commander because we're in the States. We respond to their needs, their requests. We're basically a force provider and bring specific skills to the table to assist local law enforcement and civil authorities in providing the services and protection to the people in their areas.
My name is Major Emil Dyszak. I'm from the Demilogical Response Center of Polish Armed Forces. And we are here with my soldiers to make a next step in our cooperation with soldiers from Illinois National Guard. This cooperation started 5 years ago. Last year we had a big exercise in Poland, near Warsaw, and this year we have a great opportunity to participate in exercise in Chicago. That's a partnership between Illinois National Guard and the Polish. The state of Illinois is a partnership for Poland. So okay. we have good connections, and this is the reason why we train together from 5 years. So here it's 12, and the second group is 10, and they are designated to a civil support team in another place, so we are divided to do groups to learn as much as possible.
Okay, and is it just Polish Army, or are there other forces?
Yeah,
there,
we have also participants from our Ministry of Interior, from Fire State of Poland, and from Polish FBI, and there are also another group from police.
Do you have American forces in Poland? Do you do exercises with them there?
Actually, now we have American soldiers, but that they have no connections with us because there is special forces, another kind of forces. But we had at least 3 exercises together with our colleagues from Illinois National Guard during last 4 years.
Okay.
But that was very telling, you know. So we have special forces in Poland training with their troops.
And day 4, Bensonville, terror drill involving the Boy Scouts.
Today's activities are starting with a notional event that occurred this morning with the Bensonville Police Department and other local law enforcement agencies. National Guard assets are being brought in to provide level A hazmat teams, decontamination, surveillance, presumptuous identification of suspicious material, to determine if this is part of the overall anthrax scare that is taking place or not. Intelligence that was gathered from the plane crash that took place on Sunday is leading to this area, which will also be in the Bensonville area. They will come to a distribution facility. There will be a hostage situation. They will determine that this was a staging area for distribution of an anthrax product. Boy Scouts of America are providing some volunteers that will be serving as victims and of the chemical events and the contamination, to provide people that can actually go through the medical triage, the decontamination apparatus, and those types of events. So they're basically the role players for the exercise.